It's time for another thrilling chapter in the Comic-Con Carney saga. This week, Guardians of the Galaxy, Justice League, robots, but no Lobo, and Pop Secret. What is your favorite thing about movie night? My favorite thing is being able to sit on the couch, have your family around, you're snuggled in the covers, and you're watching your favorite movie. Plus, you have popcorn that you're passing back and forth, and your dog is even sitting with you because he wants you to drop the popcorn on the ground. PopSecretLabs.com has online tools, smartphone apps to find your favorite movies and watch them whenever you want. They've even partnered with eCards in OkCupid, and you can even find a date based on what movies you like. Be sure to click the link right up top, PopSecretLabs.com. We have two Guardians of the Galaxy. Chris Pratt from NBC's Parks and Recreation has been selected to play astronaut Peter Quill, otherwise known as Star-Lord, in the upcoming Guardians of the Galaxy. Directed by James Gunn, and Latino Reviews said that Jason Momoa from Game of Thrones in the recent Conan movie got the offer right after his audition, beating out Isaiah Mustafa, Dave Bautista, and Brian Patrick. So what do you think of those two choices? Leave a comment and let us know. And what about the rumor that Steve Carell and Jim Carrey might be in the running for Rocket Raccoon and Groot? And if the toys are any indication, Iron Man 3 may be leading into the Guardians movie. Funko released images of the new pop vinyl figures, including the Deep Space suit. Could this be the Iron Man suit Tony Stark wears when he goes out into space to meet the Guardians? And the trailer for Wolverine will be in front of the new G.I. Joe movie, which is odd considering right now there's not very much promotion taking up TV time. It's almost wide open. Wolverine could be all over right now with very little competition. Wolverine's going to have a sizable role in X-Men, Days of Future Past, and there's an addition to the cast. Peter Dinklage has signed on. No word on what character he's playing, but Variety reports he will be the main antagonist, and we know the Sentinels play a big part in the story. So Boulevard Trask, maybe? Last month we told you that Haley Atwell would not be coming back to the Captain America sequel. Hold the bus. Collider posted an interview with Stanley Tucci, and he says he won't be back, but Miss Haley will. They've gotten to be good friends, and he says she'll be in a flashback at the very least. Will a flashback be the way we see Dr. Arnim Zola? Actor Toby Jones has been added to the cast of Captain America, the Winter Soldier. So will we see the human Hydra scientist or Zola the robot? Speaking of robots, no, we don't know how Agent Coulson is coming back in the S.H.I.E.L.D. TV show, but is there hope on the horizon for an order from ABC? Joss Whedon has completed filming the pilot and now it's in post-production, after which the suits at the network will decide whether or not to place an order. Meanwhile, details about Phase 3 of the movie universe have been confirmed. Ant-Man and Doctor Strange will be among the solo films. And the big rumor from the Latino reviews is that the Hulk will get his solo film. And that will be based on the Planet Hulk storyline, with World War Hulk serving as a basis for Avengers 3. And you can't talk about the Avengers without someone bringing up the Justice League movie. And Mark Miller has his ideas on why a Justice League movie won't ever work. He says the biggest challenge is that the characters are too out of date. Now, most of Marvel's superheroes came around in the 60s, but Marvel wasn't even Marvel until the 60s. Captain America has been around since 1941. He's only 3 years younger than Superman, and Joe Johnson made that movie work. What do you think about Miller's comments? Can there be a Justice League movie? That's what the executives at Warner Brothers are asking themselves after tossing out Will Beale's script, saying it's terrible. As we reported on Comic-Con Carney Prime, they're taking a wait-and-see approach and betting everything on Man of Steel. The problem they'll have, though, is if Man of Steel does super phenomenally well, they've got nothing else in development. No Flash movie, no Green Lantern sequel, no Justice League movie, no Wonder Woman, although she may still have a chance on the CW network. And it's too soon for a Batman reboot, unless it's this Batman reboot. And no Lobo either? Dwayne Johnson said the project just went away. What does that mean? Another project that's going away, at least for now, Chew. The Image comic was planned as a TV adaptation for Showtime, but writer John Layman posted on the Twitter that the cable network has passed on the project. 20th Century Fox has picked up Mind Management from Matt Kent and Dark Horse. The story centers around a government agency full of psychics, and the best of the best, Henry Lime, has a breakdown loses control of his powers, causes a disaster, and has to go on the run. It's being produced by Ridley Scott. And Valiant Comics is still going strong with a Harbinger movie now in the works. Variety reports that even though Paramount passed on the film, Valiant Entertainment has brought Steven Susko back in to write a script. And they'd like Brent Ratner to direct. Remember, Harbinger was a big hit in the 90s and was comic book of the decade, so hopefully they'll get the adaptation to write. Spider-Man 2, Paul Giamatti is Rhino. Felicity Jones is who? If we were to report that everyone is speculating that she's Felicia Hardy, the Black Cat based on guesswork after a couple comments she's made about coming on board the project, we'd just be spreading rumors. No official word on her character. And finally, are you watching Arrow? What do you think so far? Are you ready for Black Canary to show up? Well, maybe not Black Canary yet, but Alex Kingston is set to pop in as the mother of Katie Cassidy's Laurel Lance. So River Song will be playing Dinah Drake, the original Black Canary, at least in the comics. That makes three actors who have Doctor Who on their resumes, along with Harry Dresden. Not too shabby. Okay, that's it this month. Don't forget to check out Comic-Con Carney Prime every second and fourth Thursday. Plus, get your video game news on the grid every first Wednesday. And this show will be back next month, but I have to go plan a wedding, so someone else will be in the hot seat. Make sure you check out our social media, Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest. Hi-ya!
See you later.